Hello everyone, welcome back and thanks for joining me in this video. Today we're going to discuss about the file encryption in Linux system, which is separate from file system encryption, which you would do during installation or while creating a new encrypted partition. During the installation of Linux system, some distributions, Red Hat for example, ask you if you want to encrypt the file system or home directory. Ubuntu used to ask until version 18, I think, but later they dropped it because of some security issues with the underlying encryption method it was implementing. And by default, this option is not selected when the option is given to you, but if you want to encrypt it, you can select the option and system will take care of encrypting file system. However, there are a few pros and cons of encrypting file system, and without knowing them, it's not a good idea to blindly encrypt your file system, and that is why the option is not selected by default, because it might not be the best choice for everyone. So file system level encryption might protect your personal data from loss or theft, but it only works when your system is at rest and mostly popular in mobile devices. But if your system is already turned on and kernel already decrypted the file system and mounted it, it's available to anyone who would normally have access to them. So you might not get a lot of protection there. But one thing you have to remember while encrypting the file system is that during the recovery, it will add some complications and sometimes you might not be able to recover everything in full. Also, file system level encryption takes more system resources than the file and directory encryption, which we will see today. And having said that, if you're still interested in file system level encryption, we'll cover that topic in a separate future video. But today, let's discuss how we can encrypt individual files and folders using both command line and graphical mode. So to demonstrate the file encryption, we're going to use GnuPG, or some people say GnuPG. It spells GNUPG, which stands for GNU Privacy Guard or GNU Privacy Guard. And it is an open implementation of OpenPGP. PGP stands for Pretty Good Privacy. So the package should be installed by default, and the command we are going to use to encrypt and decrypt file is gpg. So I have a file called b.txt. Not sure what's in there. Okay, let's write something in there. This is encrypted file. Control D, save it. Okay, it's there. Now let's try to encrypt this file. So the command is gpg, and to encrypt, we're going to use hyphen c and give the name of the encrypted file to b.txt. So it's asking me for the passphrase. It might ask again. So now the file is encrypted and you will see the file b.txt.gpg is created, which is encrypted file. And if you try to read that file, it gives you some garbage data. So the file is encrypted, you can now read it. Now you can remove the original unencrypted file, which is b.txt. But if you're not confident that your encryption is working, you might rename or move it to somewhere else. For now, let's remove it. It's not that important data anyway. Let's now decrypt the file. And to decrypt, the same command, gpg, just simply file name. You notice that it didn't ask me for the passphrase we just entered. And the reason is by default, system caches the passphrase for a certain time. And I believe the default time is 600 seconds, but we can change that configuration so that it will ask for the passphrase every time we try to decrypt the file. And for that, so some of the older version of the GNUPG, GNUPG uses a GPG agent, which caches the passphrase for a given time. Like I said, the default is 600 seconds. And we can use the option while encrypting hyphen no use agent while we're encrypting it, gpg hyphen c and then file name. Or you can also create gpg.conf file and write no use agent there and save it. But if you're using version 2.1 and later, so mine is 2.2. If you're using version 2.9 later, you can disable the caching for the agent by creating gpg agent conf file inside the new pg folder and the command, oops. Oh. Sometimes my brain doesn't work properly, especially at night. And the command is default maxcache.ttl, 1 second. And maxcache, let's define that too, ttl, 1 second. Done. Now let's restart the agent. We can do echo reload agent pipe with cpg connect agent. Okay, now let's try one more time. Oh, now let's read that file that we decrypted. We remove the file. Now this is the decrypted file. Let's remove the GPG file one more time. And let's create GPG-c.txt. The encryption is created. It's giving me warning because GPG read this configuration file and it says it's obsolete option, no use agent, because we're using newer version, but we can ignore that part. And let's do GPG, let's remove B again. Now it asked for the password because we set up a configuration file to cache a password less than 1 second, or actually 1 second. And now the file is decrypted and we can read it. So like I said before, if you're using GnuPG, GNUPG older than 2.1, you can use this file and this configuration, which I'm gonna remove now because I don't need it. And if you're using version 2.1 and newer, you can do default hyphen cache hyphen ttl 1 second, max cache ttl 1 second, and that will force the cache system to keep cache for 1 second, and that will prompt you for the passphrase every time you want to decrypt the file. Now let's go and check how to encrypt the directories. And we have directories 018, a lot of files. So to encrypt directories, you have two options. One, you can archive it and create a file and then use GPG option like we did for the file and encrypt it. Or you can use GPG tar to archive and encrypt the file at the same time. So we are going to see both. First, let's try to create archive file and encrypt it using GPG command. So the command to archive tar czf018.tar.tz and the source file is 018. Let's create it. So now we have 018.tar.tz. You can do gpg-c 08 passphrase one more time. And now it created 018.tar.tz.gpg, which is encrypted file. And we can remove this file. Now let's do gpg. So it will decrypt the file. Now we have tar file again, and we can use tar xzf018.tar.tz. And we have let's remove the written folder and run extraction again. We have 018 folder again. There's nothing there. Okay, so that's how you can decrypt the directories. First, create archive, and archive will be treated as a file and use the GPG command like we encrypted the file. And the second option is if we have GPG tar package installed, and you can verify that using GPG tar. So it is installed in my system. If it's not installed, you can do sudo apt get install hyphen y, which will answer yes for any yes, no question utils. So I already have it installed. And that will give you GPG tar command, which we'll use to encrypt the directories. So let's make a directories, or we already have a directories. Let's use the same one. So we know that what's inside there. Okay, so we only have 018 directory. Now let's do GPG tar --encrypt. So this is the syntax. And symmetric, I'm gonna dissect this command line options. Let's first type the command into 018.gpg. I'm giving a file name, the output file name, and this is the source file. So asking for the passphrase. Okay, the file is encrypted now. I have 018.gpg. Obviously, if I do cat, there's a lot of distorted characters. So in this command, we are asking gpg tar to encrypt the file using symmetric key. By default, it uses AES 256. AES stands for Advanced Encryption Standard. It uses 256 bits algorithm to generate the key. And output file name is this. And this is our source file. So now let's decrypt it. So to decrypt, let's create one folder, decrypt, for example. And we're going to decrypt our 018.gpg there. gpg tar again. --decrypt. Now we are asking it to decrypt it. Before we gave encrypt option, and directory to decrypt is decrypt, and the file name is gpg. Okay, asking us for the passphrase, and let's go to decrypt folder. So they have 018 folder, get test 2. So now it's decrypted and you can read the file. So this is another option to encrypt and decrypt the directories. And one more thing, let's try one more thing. Remove txt.gpg, and also let's remove everything under decrypt folder. So now decrypt folder is blank, and we're going to use the same command to encrypt it. But in this one, we are going to suppress the passphrase prompt and supply the passphrase in command line. So we're going to use --gpg arguments. And the argument is passphrase. Let's do test 1, 2, 3 and that. I had to put the name of the source file at the end. So what this command is doing is encrypt using symmetric AES 256 again, which you can see somewhere here. Here. And the name of the output file. And since this gpg tar is using underlying gpg command, we have to supply gpg arguments using --gpg arg command. And this is the passphrase. And this --batch is actually suppressing the prompt. So you're supplying the passphrase in command line. It's not a good idea, especially if someone is watching you and typing the command and they can see your passphrase. But, and also it will be recorded in your history. So it's not a good idea to use this unless you delete history, you remove all the traces of the command. But this is something you can try. And it is encrypted now. And we can decrypt the same way. Decrypt. You don't need algorithm. And --directory decrypt. It is decrypted under decrypt folder. You can read the file. This is a test file. So this way you can supply passphrase during encryption and decryption. And you can use command gpg tar --list archive. So these are the list of files and folders inside that encrypted directory. And if you use desktop environment a lot, you can use that to encrypt and decrypt file. So let's go and open this one. So if you right click, you might not see encrypt option here because we have to install one package, and that is let's clear the screen. Sudo apt get install seahorse nautilus-while. I might have mistyped it somewhere. So Nautilus is the file manager for GNOME or GNOME desktop environment. So now we have that package installed. Let's go ahead and encrypt the folder. Well, actually we have to restart the file manager. And to do that, Nautilus-Q. So my file manager is closed. Now open again. And right click, we should have encrypt option here. Encrypt. So use a shared passphrase and encrypt each file separately or encrypt package together in a package. So if you click that and select tar option, it's the same thing that we did before. So now it's archiving the file and it will ask for the passphrase when it's time to encrypt it. There you go. Now this is archived and encrypted. And if we remove this file and remove this also, now we have this file, which we can open with decrypt file under the passphrase that we just used to encrypt it. And now it will create an archive file. And we can open the archive manager and actually see all of and see the file. We can also right click and extract here. So our original 018 folder is here now. There you go. So these are some simple methods you can use to protect your data from prying eyes. And file system level encryption is great, but comes with its own price, which we will discuss in a separate video later. But this is a great alternative if you're looking to protect a few files and directories and leave the system untouched. And to be honest, this is probably the best for most of the Linux users, because file system encryption should not be the choice of every user until they go through and understand fully and weigh its pros and cons carefully. So with that note, I'll end this video right here. And as always, thanks for watching and keep practicing Linux, and I'll see you in the next video.